20-meter band, but it was flat as a nail. I couldn't believe it.
Hi, guys. This is Rich, WB5YBZ. And I thought I'd try, I had NFED years ago, and I thought, well, I'm going to just try to string one up by the gutters. Some of it's touching the gutters, so you know it's not going to be as an effective, probably, as if it wasn't touching the gutters. And I just haphazardly tried to fold up the wire at the end. But let me just show you what we got here. And thanks so much for watching. If you give me a thumbs up, I'd appreciate it. If you subscribe, I'd appreciate it as well. So let's go on over and let's see the antenna. Okay, what we have here is a my antennas. It's a 49-to-1 Balun. The top one is where the antenna wire is, and if you see the little lug right here next to the coax, that's where the counterpoise is. And again, I don't know if you can see it, but there's the counterpoise. I put it about 6.5 feet just to do it, and then I had a strain going down. And you know, really, in a way, this could be almost a HOA buster type of antenna, because not very many people could see it in your backyard. But it goes on down. It's hard to see here. And again, I would put more insulators up. And it goes down the wall over here. And let me just walk over there. It sort of looks like it's darkening out because of the light. So it goes to the end of the house. And right there is the insulator, and you can see it's touching the gutter, which probably is not very good. And then it comes over here. And so I kept on pulling it up, pulling the antenna up, and I have it hooked up. And this is just a clothesline, or clothes hanger. And so I just pulled it up here. I'm thinking it's probably about 67 or 68. Probably needs to be a little shorter. Let's go inside and look at the 7300, and let me show you what we have as far as SWR.
Whiskey Bravo 5, Yankee Bravo Zulu.
Yankee Bravo Zulu. Let's see if we're talking to Richard in Oklahoma.
That's right, you're 5'9 in Oklahoma City. You're sounding great here. What are you running, and what's the antenna and transmitter, over?
Yes, sir, sounding really good this way as well, 5'9. ICOM 7300 and a home-built G5 RV that's selling Hamfest. Got it up in the tree, probably 30-something feet.
Okay, that's great. I know you want to hit some more people, but you're just booming here. You got 5 over S9 that time. So good to meet you, and good luck. KN4COEWB5YBZ will be clear. 73.
All right, thank you there, Richard. And 73, this is KN4COE2251.
Well, I'm on 40.
And okay, is that guy talking down the green? Another call from the door.
Seems like the signals are pretty strong.
Okay, I didn't really work at this. I was just wanting to hurry up and put it up. I tried to pull the wire down. I was looking at MFJ antenna analyzer when I was doing this, and I thought, well, I don't know, it's pretty close, and so I didn't really peak it. But if you can see, it's around 7, I'm guessing about 7.195 or something maybe would be the lowest part, but your antenna will be easily tuned with your antenna tuner. This is what was interesting to me. On the 20-meter band, at least between 14160 and 14280, I didn't really look around. I was sort of in a hurry. But it was flat as a nail. I couldn't believe it. But it's amazing. Now, 15 meters was a little different. If you look to the left, around 21,296, I believe it is, it looks like it's going to be lower at the lower end of the band. But I didn't go that far. I was just wanting to see what it would be. Mid-frequency was around 21,356. But still, it's basically under 2 to 1, which isn't too bad. Another surprise to me was 12 meters. And you can see the SWR, not bad at all. So, and on 10 meters, well, I'm just looking at the frequencies here. The calling frequency is usually about 28,400. But it looks like it's lower at the other, or even lower on down the band toward maybe 3 to 200, 28, 3 to 200 is probably, I'm guessing, is a lot lower than what I am showing here. For a half-wave infed, this is the formula I use approximately. For 80 meters, it's 468 divided by 3.6 megahertz. When I'm down that low portion of the band, it works out good with 40, 20, 15, and 10. You make it at 3.8 or 3.9, it'll be probably out of the band. SWR will be higher on the lower frequencies. That's why I'm putting it here. Also, if you want your counterpoise, you go 80 meters times 0.05. It's equal to 4 meters, or approximately 13 feet. Maybe a little bit more, not much. And here's 40 meters. 40 meters is 468. And again, I'm using 7.1, and your antenna length is approximately 65.9 feet. My counterpoise, 40 meters times 0.05 equals 2 meters, or around 6.5 feet. That's what I cut it for. I think it figures a little bit longer, but that's what I cut it for. It seems like it's working fairly good.
Well, I tell you what, this, my antenna balun, it goes from 80 to 10 meters. This one that says 1.5 kilowatts. I think they cut that down to about 1 kilowatt now. But you can cut it for anything you want, basically any band you want. I did 40 meters because I just had enough wire for about 40 meters. If I had wanted to go 80 meters, I would have stretched out about twice as long, I guess. But it's a really good balun. And they make a lot of balance over my antennas. I'm not getting paid for this, but I'm just telling you what I'm using here. If you're going to cut the antenna, I would suggest cut a little longer and then start trimming it back. So the SWR is good. But it still would go toward the lower end of 80 meters, even 3.550, because it just lines up. It makes a double the harmonic. It's 7.1. Theoretically, and on 20 meters, it would be 14.2. On 10 meters, it would be 28.4. You just do the harmonics of it all. Anyway, that's it. Thanks so much for watching. If you give me a thumbs up, I'd appreciate it. Or subscribe. Catch you later.